fall, you don't imagine the leaves think how comfortable it will be to touch the earth instead of the nothingness of air and the endless freshets of wind. And don't you think the trees themselves, especially those with mossy, warm caves, begin to think of the birds that will come? Six, a dozen, to sleep inside their bodies? And don't you hear the goldenrod whispering goodbye, the everlasting being crowned with the first tuffets of snow? The pond vanishes, and the white field over which the fox runs so quickly brings out its blue shadows. And the wind pumps its bellows, and at evening especially, the piled firewood shifts a little, longing to be on its way. As autumn begins to arrive with its crisp, cool mornings, rainy afternoons, and whispers its poetry of colors in auburn, gold, and ochre, I begin to feel at home. I love so much about this season. Its color palette, the weather, the cozy nights at home, big chunky sweaters, warm spiced drinks, and deliciously baked goods. Autumn just fills my soul with a warmness and wholeness than any other season. Each year I look forward so much to whenever September comes around and I can begin to enjoy in the delights of autumn. So today, that is what we are going to do together. To celebrate the first of autumn, I want to do as many fall activities as I can fit in. After a slow, gentle morning of coffee and reading, I wanted to create a visual mood board of autumn with a collection of books I have. And then we will pull out a box of autumn decorations and fill our cozy little tiny home. I then want to bake a fall-inspired treat, as well as make an autumn craft I have been so excited to make ever since I saw a picture that inspired me. So go on and cozy on up with your favorite fall sweater or blanket, grab a deliciously hot drink, and join me as we get in the autumn spirit together. Thank you. The air is crisp with autumn promise, fills the senses with the smoky scent of a fired up wood-burning stove. A woodland fairy dances past us, carrying colorful leaves of yellow and orange. She twirls and twirls until she is quite dizzy, scattering puffs of dirt and dust into the air. We hear her voice singing a sweet invitation to run and caper beside her tiny frame. Her magical laugh tickles our ears as we learn to accept the unexpected. The trees prepare themselves for bed as we hunker down for the night, warm beneath our hand-crafted feather quilt. The air is crisp and scintillating outside. We see dots of light as the woodland fairy dances past our window one more time.